Augustine said, seek not to understand that you may believe, but believe that you may understand.
In the four centuries since Augustine wrote, many advances have been made in our understanding of the scripture.
I only meant that, scripture alone...
Enough! I will not hear another word! The scripture alone! This is bordering on blasphemy!
Blasphemy? No, no, brother!
Never speak again until you have learned to obey God's will, and not your own!
You would force a vow of silence simply because God gave me an inquiring mind?
Ah! Blasphemy! Blasphemy!
Venite adoremus et ada talata merum, eritis et fidem, dus et vos interam et promissa, in tua erit anima domini mea
Alfred's emissaries spend a few days here. Someone may know where he went.
Welcome!
I must take my leave. So long.
You tried to catch flies, or would you ask something of me?
I'm looking for a man. He passed through here on the king's business.
Oh, bugger off, eh? Or I'll call the guards. I'm sick of people. You need to heal your own ills.
How about you help me from the goodness of your heart, and then I'll leave you alone?
A wise move, Mudwit. It so happens I did see Alfred's man. He's long gone, though. Maybe Gawain the Bard knows where.
Where will I find him?
Well, he was pissed as a newt. Last I saw, he was passed out in trees between the arbor and bridge. Oh, now go find someone else to vex.
There was a bard drinking with the emissary. I should find him, see if he knows anything. That ale-swamped scob can't have gone far.
course, that spear thrust.
Someone stole my troops.
You there! You alive!
Patience is a tired horse. Ploddity plod plod.
Another tottering teat sucker who can't hold his drink. Let's clear your head. Are you the tale weaver?
Gawain the Dandelion. For the seeds of my stories flit upon the winds of Wessex. But why, mule, do you kick my noggin?
You and Alfred's emissary were drinking in the tavern. Tell me where he went.
Were we? I was so ale-addled. Perhaps a small and silver thing upon my palm might help me recall?
How about something long and sharp in your gut?
All right, no need for that. You paint a vivid picture, Dane. He was headed to the White Coast to the southeast. Dover Fortress. He said it is where they train those religious fanatics. Zealots. They pray all night instead of sleeping.
My thanks, and in return, wisdom. Too much beer piping will grow a fool in wit and words.
My thanks, Weaver of the Obvious. Now leave me to my unholy punishment.
The emissary made for Dover Fortress on the southeast coast.
Thank you.
keep on here!
No more winters for you.
Better to die than face my lords. I hope my Magister Magnus forgives me. For so long, I looked to him for guidance, for order.
If your honor is slow, a true lord cannot forgive you. They cannot.
Now I will turn my gaze to Warden, Tiwar, and Shunor. I will continue to turn until I find some forgiveness.
You will spin and drill yourself to an endless bottom. over. The emissary's somewhere here. Perhaps I can find the letter without bloodshed. The bard said paladins trained at this fortress. This will not be an easy fight.
All right. Well, you'll have to get down somehow. Can you see a haystack or something?
A haystack? Are you mad? From this height? That's certain death! No! My fate is sealed! I will just wait up here to die!
Someone is stuck.
My brother. Chasing some foolish legend that if you see old Hissa from above and catch his tail, he will grant you a wish.
And what of your leg?
Likely sprained, trying to climb up to rescue him. We are a sorry pair. Looking like a laying hen. I'm the one with the broken leg. At least grab old Hissa's tail while you're up there.
Something is hissing. Jormungandr's friend. Are there snakes up here too?
All right. Well, you'll have to get down somehow. Can you see a haystack or something?
A haystack? Are you mad? From this height? That's certain death? No, my fate is sealed. I will just wait up here to die! Hulk's golden bristles, Rodin! How did I let you get here to this?
Looking like a laying hen. I'm the one with the broken leg. At least grab old Hissa's tail while you're up there.
Something is hissing. Jormungandr's fangs. Are there snakes up here too?
All right. Well, you'll have to get down somehow. Can you see a haystack or something?
A haystack? Are you mad? From this height? You made it up. You truly are a brave one.
I'll help you down, but how is a big, strong Norse like yourself afraid of heights?
And snakes! I don't know how I let my brother talk me into these schemes. I think I just give in to his endless scolding. But I'm sick to the back teeth of him. Climb up, Arne! Go in that cave of wolves, Arne! Eat that red mushroom!
Siblings are a source of great joy and equal misery. I too have a brother.
Does yours put you in the maw of death every opportunity he gets?
Come, let's get you down, and perhaps you can tell him how you feel.
Talk of my feelings to my brother? I would rather let the snakes gnaw on my tender parts.
This way?
It's too high to get down from here.
There, the ladder. Watch your step.
Which way now?
This way?
There! Another slithering devil waiting to get me. Yes! I'm alive! Brother! Yes! I'm alive! Brother!
Thank you, stranger, for bringing this waste of breath back to me.
You're welcome. But what is the story you spoke of? Old Hissar?
A pretty legend. He who catches old Hissar's tail will find her heart's wish granted. We have followed England's legends and found little but peril. It's time to hang up our well-worn boots.
Farewell. May Odin litter your path with riches.
Goodbye. Keep each other safe. For a good brother is the truest treasure from the gods.
Now see, you big lump. All that wailing, it was as easy as a hop and a jump.
Ha ha ha, keep that up, and I'll leave you here for the wolves. Oh, no. Look at your leg. Is it truly broken?
No, sprained is all. But I'd like to see you get by without me. Couldn't even climb down a ladder without mewing like a newborn.
King's word, but there's no hand to put it in.
The guards here are vigilant.
Off with you.
If I could steal the letter without killing the emissary, it would keep me out of trouble. Alfred's chosen Elderman is a thing called Tegmund. The Abbot Cynibert will want to know. I should meet Basim and the Abbot in Fulkenstein.
Hold on! Nothing!
with you. I'll ring him back.
I do a roaring trade at Reculver and Tunbridge. They pay well for my catch.
The monks? Do those parchment-skinned Christians ever eat meat?
Don't you believe in Jesus? They refrain.
It's rare to see Abbot Kinnebert down this way.
Abbot who?
You know, the rich one. The monastery that brews ale. He keeps half the menfolk in the county from their wives.
Ending up with an ale-soused wastrel is another reason I've not taken a husband.
If you're waiting for a sober one, you'll die an old maid.
Oh, you must try my ale sometime. You must. My abbey brews the best in Kent.
It certainly sounds worth the risk of my immortal soul.
Ah, your god is rather a hard taskmaster.
And your god forbids the mixing of wool and linen. It sounds to me like he's never heard of England.
Not all that is written in the scriptures is God's honest truth.
One more time, I'm telling you. If he says my boots are dirty or my hair needs combing, I will split him open.
You're full of swamp gas. You'll do what you always do. Bow and scrape to our good thane Tedmund.
I'm not even sure it's him we're working for.
Don't be daft. Who else would it be? A changeling spirited there by fairy folk? Get back to patrol.
Eivor, you have news?
Kent's new elderman will be Thane Tedmund.
Tedmund? Oh, the Lord is testing me. He is made mouse by you Danes. Barely leaves his fortress at Rucester. How might I gain his influence if he will not speak to me? Or to anyone? It is a puzzle.
To inspire loyalty, Tedmund must owe you something. Such is his life.
Go on.
A fortress stormed. A man kidnapped. If you beat back his enemy, saved him from sure death, his gratitude would be...
Swell. It would know no bounds. But that fortress will be harder to pry open than a nun's knees.
Perhaps. Perhaps not.
Are you hiding something, Bessem?
There is a lumber mill nearby, correct?
Beamersfield. Alfred invests much in fortifying Wessex, and uses our forests to do so. The mill provides his wood.
Tedmund is there.
Impossible! How do you know?
I heard rumors that Tedmund had been lured out of self-exile to manage work on the fortifications of Canterbury.
Taking him from a lumberyard is less dangerous than assaulting a fortress, but your rescue attempt will not have the same flair. Is it worth it?
It may still work. Yes. Yes. Bring him to the megaliths.
And Fulke?
When I have Tedmund's fealty, you shall have Fulke. Now go. I will rustle up a small rescue party.
Fresh from rattling skulls and rattling bones.
I'm wary of this abbot, Bessem. He is self-serving and evasive. Can he really deliver Fulke?
The abbot is a friend of Fulke's. That is clear.
So long as he doesn't suspect our motive, we may have a chance.
Indeed. This brings to mind a story. Perhaps you've heard of it. The Scorpion and the Frog.
A children's story?
A cautionary tale. The scorpion wants to cross the river, but he cannot swim. So he enlists the help of the frog. The frog agrees to carry him on his back, extracting a promise that the scorpion will not sting him.
Let me guess, the scorpion reneges, blaming his nature, and both drown.
The scorpion crosses the river and stings an innocent man, killing him. So what does this tale tell us?
That your stories are clouded, and their meaning doubly so?
It shows that every tale has a thousand possible outcomes, many of which are surprising. If the abbot does not deliver Fulke, he will die at my hand. And we will continue our search.
A sobering approach.
Eivor, stay close.
Beamersfield is just ahead. Lead. I will follow.
I hope this chase will catch us a plump hen.
Once the abbot has Tedmund's gratitude, he will deliver Fulke. It will cost us nothing more than this.
If that leaden wit keeps his word.